Hello, hi, welcome to this video. This is Arvind here. So we look at the trade setup and market view for the week starting 2nd of November. It's a new series. Okay, so the Nifty daily chart, you can see Nifty has been forming spinning top pattern for the last 2 days, and it's in a very tight range between 11,540, the low which was formed on Friday, and 11,730 is the supply zone. So it's in a very tight range. Any kind of momentum on either side will confirm the further trend. Right now there's a strong support at 50 DMA. You can see here 11,540-550 range, and that from there we saw a pullback recovery, right? So as long as that holds, I think there is more upside. So good chance Nifty may find support here and start going up, but on the upside there is limited movement can be expected. You can see 11,800 and 928. Both these are strong support, strong supply zones. From there, we can see some selling pressure coming in. That's what happened. You can see there have been multiple attempts to break out above 12,000. A lot of times Nifty was unable to break out, and we saw some very high selling pressure. From there, we started to fall. So it'll be a very tight range for this week, but a lot of things depend on the US elections outcome. So that will be a crucial event for the week, which will confirm further market direction. But as per price action, there is a chance that we may see some kind of upside momentum in Nifty. There's a good chance we will go up to 11,750-800 zones, and from there we can see some selling pressure coming in. That's a possibility. So as of now, as long as 11,500-550 zone is protected, we can stay long. With a stop around 11,480-490, that's a good stop for long trades. And once we go to 11,750-800, that we can see some shorting opportunities also. Now coming to Bank Nifty, Bank Nifty is also range bound. It tested the 20-day moving average and started to pull back from there. And it's got very strong support between 23,900 to 24,000. So as long as it stays above, there is a chance it may go up to 24,500. And 25,000 is the strong supply zone. So again, we can expect some kind of pullback recovery with ICICI Bank results, IndusInd Bank results. That may have a positive impact. And on the downside, support comes at 23,500, and 23,176 is a very strong support at 200-day moving average. Any kind of fall to these levels can be buying opportunities. So you can see Bank Nifty has got a very strong support here. So this is the line which we have to look for. Now coming to global market scenario, US markets closed negative on Friday, you can see here, and Europe also was on the negative side, right? So we have to see from this levels, are we going to see a pullback or not? You can see, let's go to Dow Jones chart in a little bit detail. You can see Dow Jones has formed a double top kind of a formation and holding support here. This is a very strong support, the 200-day moving average, which is around 26,200 range. That is exactly got tested here, and we saw a good recovery, but still it closed negative. So any kind of recovery from here, we can see further consolidation and good recovery. Again, a lot of things depend on the result. We don't know how markets will react as per who's winning the election. Right, on the downside there is support at 25,600 and 2500. So there is a, on the worst case scenario, there's a possibility of a 500 to 1000 point decline on Dow Jones. That is where the next support zones come in. But as long as it's staying above 2600, it is a strong support for Dow Jones. Right, now coming to S&P 500 is still far away from 200-day moving average. It has also formed a double top formation here, but still there is not much of a downside below. Only if it breaks 3200, there is going to be more downside left in S&P 500. So there is a good chance of consolidation here also. So being in major support zones, it's quite difficult to predict anything. We have to see if it's holding support and recovering, or it's going to break down. A breakdown will again cause further fall. Another say 100 point fall can be expected in S&P 500, right? So coming to FII data, FIIs are back to selling after buying for a few days. You can see here they're back to selling, which is in cash market, which is something which we have to take note of. So further selling pressure can induce more fall in Nifty. See, SGX Nifty, even though we tested 11,580, it showed very good 50-60 point recovery towards close. That is a good sign. So there's also a possibility of a pullback in Nifty. Maybe we can open flat or with a positive bias on Monday, given the fact that Reliance has already come out with very good results. And as per Reliance chart, you can see it is taken support at 2000 levels, so very, very strong support. And there is a good trend reversal pattern that is forming here, and I think it is moving to 2100 zones. So good long trading opportunity. So it may possibly open with a gap up. And on the upside, I think 2100 to 2150 can be expected in Reliance, and that may cause a good rally in Nifty itself, which we may go to 11730, 750 zones. That is the trade in Reliance. So also coming to crude oil charts, it showed a lot of weakness last week. You can see here big fall of almost 1500 points in 1 week, and it's also already had a breakdown below crucial support zones. Right now it looks weak and closing toward the low point of the day, and there's a lot of selling pressure, which is also causing good rally in paint-based stocks. Asian Paints, Berger Paints, Pidilite, these stocks were showing good traction. So if this fall continues, we can still get buying opportunities there in these kind of stocks. But on the chart, this looks weak. So unless there's a pullback, there could be more shorting opportunities here, expecting more fall in crude oil. That is my opinion. So that's about for the week. I hope you have a good trading sessions. Whatever views I'm sharing is purely based on my own research. If you take any positions, please do your own research or consult your financial advisor. So once again, have a good trading week, and especially this one point on the index. Right now it is between the major trading zones, 11,000 to 12,000, right? So if you're trading, looking for a big move on either side, just hedge your positions. That will be helpful to you. Just a tip. And that's about it. Take care and trade well. Thank you for watching. Bye bye.